Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. We're going to discuss perimeter in this video. So first of all, what is the perimeter? It's the distance around some figure. So for instance, let's say you had some figure like that, and these had certain lengths. Let's just say this was in inches, for instance, and let's say that's 8, that's 4, that's 5, that's 7, and that's 4. So I'm going to just put inches on it for now. Then the perimeter is just the distance around it. So the perimeter, I'll just call it P for perimeter. You would just add all those sides together, and I'm going to leave off the inches for now, but you would just add the 4, the 5, the 7, the 4, and the 8. So what does that give you? Let's see, we have 12 and 12, 24, 28. So it would be 28 inches. Okay, it's just how far around it is in a figure. Now, in general, you might have something with, different sides, and you just add the sides. So if you had A, B, C, and D, the perimeter is you just add the sides. So if you had something with 20 sides, you would be adding 20 sides. If you had something with 3 sides, like a triangle, you would only be adding 3 sides. So here's the formula for the perimeter of a triangle. It doesn't matter what your triangle looks like, there are 3 sides. The perimeter will just be the sum of the 3 sides. So once you understand what perimeter is, it's not like you have to memorize the formula. You're just adding the 3 sides of that figure. All right, let's talk about the perimeter of a square. Well, in a square, they're all 90 degree angles here, right? And all the sides are the same, so they're all x. So the perimeter, again, you just add the 4 sides. So what's an easier way of writing that? What's x plus x plus x plus x? That would be 4x. Now sometimes people use an s or some other letter, but it doesn't matter what letter you use. You just take one of the sides and multiply it by 4, and you've got the perimeter of a square. All right, let's talk about the perimeter of a rectangle. Now, a square is also a rectangle, but usually when you talk about a rectangle, one of the sides is longer than the other side. We usually call the longer side the length and the shorter side the width. So this is more of what a rectangle might look like. So if this is L, this side over here is also L, and this side over here is the same as W. So again, we're just adding the 4 sides up. So we have W plus L plus W plus L. And then when you add the like terms, you get 2W plus 2L. Now, if you know a little bit about algebra, that's the same thing as twice whatever W plus L adds up to. If you factor out a 2, or you could think of it this way. If you went halfway around, okay, that would be W plus L, but then you have to double that, right? So you have W plus L, and then you have to double it. So both of these are valid form, all three of these are valid formulas for the perimeter of a rectangle. You most commonly see it this second way. So in other words, if you were looking at formulas in books, usually it's written like that, or it might be 2L plus 2W. Another way of doing it, this is a little bit non-traditional, is saying the width plus the length. So if I only go halfway around, that's half the perimeter. So that's the perimeter divided by 2. Sometimes I think about it that way. I know if I go halfway around, it's only half of the perimeter. But these are all really equivalent to each other. So that's how we get the perimeter of a rectangle. We're going to do one more, the perimeter of a circle. Now, the word we use for the perimeter of a circle is the circumference. So usually people say, what's the circumference of the circle? But it does mean how far is it all the way around. Well, in a circle, there's the center in the middle. I mean, there's this point in the middle of the circle. The circle is really just the, you know, this line out on the outside. And we have a diameter that's all the way across through that center point. Half of that is called R, the radius. So D is called the diameter, and it's all the way across. And R is called the radius, and D is twice as long as R is, so it's 2 times R. It's R plus R, or 2 times R. There are two formulas for the circumference of a circle, so instead of writing P, we write a C. We have this irrational number pi, which is approximately 3.14, or approximately 22/7, times D, pi D. So if you take this irrational number pi and multiply it by the diameter, you've got the circumference of the circle. Another formula that you will see is 2 pi r. Now, notice it's funny that they put this pi in the middle. I like to think of it as 2 r times pi, but, you know, it's the same thing. Basically, 2 r is the same thing as d. So again, this could be written as d times pi. The most common one you'll see is it written as pi d or 2 pi r for the circumference. So for our 3 and 4 sided figures here, the most common ones are the triangle, the square, and the rectangle. Here are the main formulas. And then we have the circumference of a circle. The most common formulas you'll see are written as C equals 2 pi r, or C equals pi d. So now that you know the formulas, you should be able to work some problems using these formulas. But mostly it's common sense, except for the circumference of a circle. That's a little bit hard to understand, right? So you do have to memorize those. But the perimeter of a triangle and a square and a rectangle, hopefully it makes sense why those are the formulas. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.